What's up, everybody? It's Man of Low Moral Fiber here. My name's Luke, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Boom Puppy as a part of my Does It Suck series for a second time. The first time we looked at it with Krieg, and I concluded that it very much did indeed suck, and quite a bit. But some people had asked to see it with Axton, so I'll oblige them and we'll see how it does here. I am going to be using it in combination with a Legendary Soldier comm, which I found to do more damage than the Expert Grenadier comm. I've decided to use the Torgue Allegiance Relic. I guess we could also use the Explosive Damage Relic, and both would probably yield similar results. I think the Torgue, though, will give a slightly higher DPS with this weapon. I also have on a Sham Shield, because this weapon will very much kill you. And with the Sham Shield, it's less likely to do that, obviously. So that's why I'm using that. You can see it very much absorbing those grenades there. It'll be interesting to see if we can do any good damage with it. I'll have the Quasar to group some enemies up, and that'll deal some damage, which should assist the weapon. But it's interesting to see how the weapon would actually perform if you were trying to use it in a somewhat useful scenario. This particular map, the Washburn Refinery, does have a lot of walls and enemies that are kind of in positions like this, where... You know, I think we might be able to get half-decent usage out of this, because the explosion should also deal damage to this guy. And so, we took him out in a fair amount of time. It wasn't totally pitiful. There are weapons that could have definitely killed him quicker, but that's not the Boom Puppy at its absolute worst. In open areas is where the Boom Puppy really fails to perform. So, hopefully, we can... get enemies kind of grouped up, kind of where we want them, I guess. That way, it's more likely that we could deal good damage to them by either lining them up and letting it bounce through multiple enemies, or perhaps instead just get enemies really close to walls, which would make it possible to kill them as well. Surprisingly, quick charge is kind of keeping my health up there, or my shield up, which was then protecting my health bar from that corrosive dot we caught from the... corrosive barrel. So even with a low capacity shield, you can really see Axton's shield tanking abilities there if you're activating his kill skills like quick charge, or his kill skill quick charge in specific. Alright, so these guys are, you know, kind of close up like this. The power loader is really a bad usage scenario for this weapon because, you know, it can bounce them back at you. Luckily, the sham shield I have on is kind of helping with that. Hey, look, I accomplished Ammo Eater 4. So that's one thing we might get going in this particular video. I'm going to try to work through the Washburn Refinery here in this video. Or I'll just go until I die, one of the two. But, you know, we're just trying to use this weapon at all. I think it's pretty clear that this weapon, you know, does kind of suck. We were getting plenty of help from the Quasars there. But I think that's really the only way to effectively use this weapon is to try to back multiple enemies at once into a corner where then you could then benefit from the AoE damage and the repeating explosions and everything. So I have this guy kind of in a corner right now. It might help, you know, but he's walking away from it now, so I don't know. You can just see how we're barely outdoing his health regeneration there, which is pretty damn poor, to be honest. Jeez, that guy almost killed us. Ah, gun loaders over here, too. Interesting. So, I tried to throw it past that guy and into that corner, but it got stuck on him, so... didn't really work out. Didn't put either enemy where I wanted it. So, we're kind of really in a bad spot right now. There's an exploder coming, too, so... eh, we'll have our turret back very shortly, and then maybe we can group up on this little garage or whatever that thing is. And the Quasar will kill the bull loader, so that worked out, too. So that looked good. You know, there was such an angle right there that, and such a collection of nearby surfaces that it wrecked this one gun loader. So there are specific instances where this weapon will not suck. There are specific instances where it will perform pretty well. Not as good as the Kerblaster, which is pretty much an easier to acquire weapon. I don't know. It's easier to farm for a specific Kerblaster, perhaps. Even then, I guess you could just quest farm using the read-only... you know, method with the Boom Puppy. Regardless, the Kerblaster is just as easy to acquire, almost, and obviously a lot more powerful. So there's really not a need for this weapon in any way, shape, or form, but we're not going to let that stop us from trying to use it here. So I'm trying to line this up in such a way that maybe, you know, just maybe we could get good action here off the wall behind him and get multiple explosions. Now he's kind of walked away, so there's less of a chance of that, but who knows? Looks like he's blown up our turret at this point, so I've initiated retreat procedures. Yeah. He can't hit us from that angle with that weapon, so yeah. He has Torgue rifles, though, which kind of suck. Technically, I have a Torgue rifle, but it sucks, so we're kind of in a weird position here. Now, with him right up against the wall, you can see how some of those numbers are appearing fairly frequently and stuff. That's good. That lets us know that he's in a position right now that is kind of compromising against the Boom Puppy. So we tried to make use of that, and it looks like we were able to take him out. This weapon does use 3 ammo per shot. I'm using this Torgue Allegiance Relic to increase the magazine size. Otherwise, our fire rate effectively would be drastically decreased because we would have to reload so often. With 25 in the magazine with the Torgue Grip, that only gives you 9 shots per magazine, and you need a lot more than 9 shots to kill enemies with this weapon. So that's one of the reasons I'm wearing the Torgue Allegiance Relic right now. And it also increases the fire rate so we can get more bullets out there quicker and, you know, have more potential damage out there as well. There'll be a couple power loaders in here. Power loaders are especially bad for this because they reflect the grenades back onto you, you know, like they do with most weaponry. But it should be possible to group them up here and try to get good damage on them. If this one would fall back into here, that would be best. Kind of in the kill zone, but he's taking a little while to walk back into that area. Ugh. This weapon is so very, very bad. Obviously, I could use my turret to kind of stop them a little bit, but I just want to group them up back here. And then maybe we can get something going on them. I don't know. Ugh, it's so pitiful. Some of those are coming back to hit me. So, you know, with the random surfaces and everything that exist on all the maps, it is just very, very difficult to predict where these are going to bounce sometimes. And, you know, if you're not wearing the sham shield, it's almost an inevitability that you'll kill yourself with this weapon, especially at high levels. So that's one of the many reasons you wouldn't want to use this weapon and use, you know, the myriad of other options. This could very well be one of the absolute worst weapons in the game. I guess I need to take a look at the Chilean and determine exactly how bad it is. I've never really actually used that weapon just because I read the description on it and I was like, well, that's fucking useless. So I don't know. Maybe I'll test that one out. And this is definitely a strong candidate, though, because without the use of the sham shield or another high absorb rate shield, you're going to kill yourself with this weapon. And beyond that, it sucks at killing things. It really, you know, is just the worst of all worlds here. Okay, so let's group them up. Quasars have done a good amount of damage. They actually killed one of them. See, I don't want to put all the damage out there with Quasars, but it's really the only half-effective way to use this weapon, you know, is to group multiple enemies up at a time and try to use it that way, or pull multiple enemies or a single enemy into a cornered area and try to use it that way. That guy kind of walked into what was a fairly optimal situation for Boom Puppy use. We're getting kind of lucky here that we're getting 2 exploders instead of real enemies, because that could, you know, pose an actual threat to us. Oh, it looks like we've got our big friend already here as well. So if he stays in that hallway, which he probably won't do, but might if the turret is right there, I might be able to get some good damage on him. Hey, look at that. See? Like, there are situations where this weapon is, like, fairly powerful. There are just so few and far between that, you know, we even had to kill ourselves here to find one of these. So that should be fairly illustrative of how bad this weapon sucks. That said, it killed a, you know, super badass loader in an amount of time that wasn't truly disgraceful. It was pretty damn bad. And then we killed that guy too. So, you know, that's interesting, but it was a very, very, very bad weapon. It's definitely got to be one of the worst in the game. So, we'll continue here. I mean, we can make it through a map using it and a, myriad of other tools and skills and everything, but pretty much any weapon would do a lot better. Not every weapon, but this isn't even one of Axton's appropriate solutions to any problem. And some novelty weapons, they're at least fun to use. This one, it's not really fun to use because it just sucks so damn bad. I mean, there's no real two ways about it, so. Maybe this guy's now in a spot, especially with him also taking mad turret damage, that he'll die. Or maybe he's in a spot that the grenades will all bounce back and kill us, which was definitely happening there for a little bit. Preparation will get my health back up, though, which is wonderful. I don't know if we'll be able to kill this exploder without him blowing up. Hey, we did it. Obviously, at range, this weapon tremendously suffers. With that guy being all sawed off and everything, I don't know if some of our grenades are bouncing over him that would otherwise hit him. But, at the very least, he was near a wall, which was probably helping in some capacity. Keep in mind, without the sham shield, we would not be able to play this aggressively, especially with this weapon. So, and we would have died many times over. You see me absorbing many of shots right now. This is a perfect sham, so that's worth keeping in mind. Okay, usually with a shit weapon, I open this door up beforehand, but that time I had forgot about it, and I put myself in a very, very compromised position there. Oh well. So when he's right there with all those walls surrounding him, and we have Battlefront active, it did decent damage. If the turret would slag that guy, that'd be wonderful, and we can continue to try to deal half-decent damage to him. Neat. Alright. Might as well take a look at our assault rifle ammo count. It's actually getting severely low, so that's bad news as well. We've almost made it, though. Assault rifle is a very deep ammo pool. Alright, so we have one bull loader here. Might as well put the turret... Oh, that was a bad spot for it. But it resulted in a pretty good spot for this guy, I would have to imagine, so... He walked out of it pretty quickly, though. He's still in a half-decent spot. Is that gonna kill him? I don't know. Couldn't see his health bar. He died, though, so that was good. Jeez, oh Pete. Very unlikely that we'll get a second win just with that, so I'm going to throw a couple of these to help me. That was awful. This gun is really, 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 really bad. There's no two ways about it. There's no mitigating this gun's atrocity. It is just pitiful. I mean, there are a very few select situations where it might kill an enemy fairly speedily, but most of the time it's just garbage. Coupled with that is the fact that it will most likely kill you as well, even with a sham shield. But perhaps its shittiest feature is the incredible lack of damage that it does. It is just garbage. Even in situations where it performs its best, there's a myriad of other weapons that would perform better. God, it's terrible. Alright, we shall continue. Well, as far as the question, does it suck concerning the boom puppy, the answer is a resounding yes. This weapon is pitiful. I was hoping there was going to be an enemy down there. That might have actually been a decent use case for it, but whatever. So So right now I'm trying to rebound off that wall back there and into this guy. It appears to be working. He's at least, you know, showing damage counters. But at the same time, he's obviously not dying. So it's worth noting that it took this many rounds to kill this guy. Ugh, it's so incredibly and terribly bad. There's just, it's awful. All right. And at range, it obviously really suffers. When you boost your magazine size by like 84% and it still takes more than two magazines to kill an enemy, that's a bad weapon. This guy's like, oh, I'm gonna run to pop a pervy. Then you'll be fucked. Except he's not four player health scaled anymore. So unless the, yeah, unless the sham doesn't protect us, we might survive. Or he's still OP8, he's just not four player health scaled. So that's good stuff. Ugh, I can't even tell what's happening. The visual pollution is so strong. Apparently this one non-slag junk loader has just been wrecking us. I don't know what's happening. Looks like we killed another one, so that's good. Game being ultra stingy with grenades. Not necessarily good. Looks like we did somehow kill Pervy, though, so good stuff. Ooh, there were mad explosions flying off of him for a minute there. That's good when you see that happening. But even when it wasn't, even when it is happening, he's not dying. So that sucks. Dude just walks right through this shit. He doesn't seem to care. There we go. There should be one more way back here. Come over here. Oh, this gun's pitiful. Okay. So, there it is. That's as far as I'm going to go. if you're not convinced the Boom Puppy sucks by now, I don't know what else I could do. It is truly one of the absolute worst weapons in the game. And there's really no build that really benefits from it. The Ker Blaster, if I have it on me, is a far superior weapon. It is a far superior weapon that absolutely, is much better than this one. So there's really no need for the Boom Puppy at all. It is one of the worst parts of a very, very bad DLC. So, yeah, you can just see how much better the Ker Blaster is just by the fire rate alone. Regardless, the Boom Puppy is absolutely pitiful. So, as always, guys, thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you haven't yet taken the time to subscribe, please do so. I'd appreciate that as well. Otherwise, I do hope to catch you next time. Bye, guys.